As well as you can take photos or videos at any point that you like. I don't take you into the Area 51 area where you can't take pictures and video. So everything we have here is public knowledge. You know, we invite.
this is an example of a truck camper gray tank. And I use it as an example of that design process I was talking to you about. So we've been building truck campers for 53 years. You know, it's what built our company. And one of the things that building truck campers really instilled in us as a manufacturer and as a design philosophy, you know, fundamental part of when we're looking at something, the first thing we always think about is maximizing space. And you guys can see, when you build a different truck camper, okay, say I'm gonna build a new truck camper for you. And it's gonna be three outputs that are gonna show you on the camera. This is where we're beginning to do some of our plumbing areas. You see the wiring for the truck campers as we continue to walk. Here in the electrical department is an example of some of those wiring harnesses I was talking about earlier. Remember, really neatly taking in a bunch of those wiring, making a plug-and-play system. This is make sure your whole wiring system a lot neater and a lot easier to access in the future. As well as I mentioned, it makes sense. Hey, getting fiberglass in my hands. So here's a visual for all you guys. Excuse me. You can get a look at the inside of that lamination sandwich I was talking about. If you peek in here, so here you can really see for that first layer of fiberglass, layer of Azdale, block foam insulation, another layer of Azdale, and then the interior of the core. And because we started with all those big pieces of block foam and we only cut out what we needed, you guys will note there's no dead space anywhere within this wall. One of the things that makes our coach Four Seasons coach is that right there. It's those materials and the way that we maximize not having any dead space to make sure that that overall box is as well insulated as possible.
Good hard work. I could watch it all day. comes back up.
Right here. There's a bug goes here. It'll snap. So when this goes down, they'll hold it from falling down.
And you got bicycle storage or something else like that in there?
You could probably use this for anything else.
Yeah. That's awesome. Thank you, sir.
You're welcome.
$2,375, right?
Correct.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Wonderful.
We just finished doing the $2,285. Oh,
$2,285. Mm-hmm. Now, do we know where this one is in particular is headed?
This one?
Yeah.
Where does it head? It's going. Right now, once we're done, it's gonna go to the yard. And then they'll call it when it's going to be ready for them.
But I mean, as far as you don't know where in America it's going to go.
Well,
I was going to that dealer, but we don't know
where. Oh, dealer? It's a dealer.
Curtis Trailers.
Curtis Trailers, huh? Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, we'll have to look that up and find out where Curtis Trailers is. Thank you guys for letting me look.
You're welcome.
So there you have it. $2,375 coming off the production line. Special thank you to the Lance Camper Factory. Thank you for watching my video, and I hope to see you out on the road.